Hey, what's going on, my beautiful people out there? I know it's been a long time since I've posted a video, but this was an issue that I spent a lot of time trying to figure out, and I thought that it might help somebody else out, so I figured I might as well make a video about it. Before I begin, I just want to say Happy Pride Month to my fellow LGBTQ+ people, and I also want to say a belated happy Memorial Day to all of my military people out there. So I appreciate you and the work that you do, and to everybody else, what's up? All right, let's hop into this video. So if you've run into this issue where you're working in Revit and you go to plot out your project and send it to PDF, and then you end up getting something that looks like this, yeah, I know, not ideal. So I spent hours trying to figure out what the issue was. I was changing settings within PDF. I was uninstalling and reinstalling fonts and all kinds of stuff. So I'm happy to say that I did find a fix for this problem. And if this is your issue, if you're working with non-native fonts, which is what I was working with, if we hop over into Revit, you can see that this is plain English. And this is the result of what I got when I tried to print this out. So, the font that I'm using, if I click on this text box here, is Arial Nova Condensed Light. And so, since that's not a native font, I had to download it onto my computer, and there's some kind of issue where I don't know if it's a Revit issue or if it's a computer issue or a PDF issue. I'm not sure. I think it might be a computer issue, but I'm going to tell you what the fix is. So before we do that, I'm just going to Control P to print just to show you that that was the results that I got when I tried to print. We're just going to print this current window that we have. I'll hit OK to do a little test print here. You'll see that I've already done one. We'll just add a two. Hit save. And again, we have this very interesting language that my computer decided to use in place of this font that it couldn't figure out. So, the fix that I found, we're going to be quick and dirty about this. Control P to print again. We'll go into properties. And this sneaky little setting right here, rely on system fonts only, do not use document fonts. If you uncheck that, hit OK again, we're gonna say corrected this time because I know it's gonna work. Hit save. And look at that! It worked! Isn't that crazy? What a silly little setting that, unfortunately, took me hours to find, and I'm hoping that you're finding this video early on in your exploratory process and trying to figure this issue out. And I hope that this helps you out. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up because that really helps out my channel a lot. It helps other people find tutorials like this. And if you haven't already, subscribe because why not? That lets YouTube know that you like content like this and it'll give you more of it. Again, I want to say thank you to all of my people out there. I appreciate you. I know I haven't been here in a while, but I expect to be around a lot more in the future. So I hope you have a great day. I know we got a purple background. Things are getting weird. Be weird with me. Why not? Let's be weird together. All right, I'll see you next time. See ya.